Hey, it's Peter Gregg in Miami, Florida, and I have got the delightful, wonderful, amazing new Canon 70D. Yeah, there's a lot of other cameras that are amazing. In the area of video, though, this one just, wow, is head and shoulders above the other ones because of its focusing capabilities. You're looking at me, right? Handsome young guy, very, very young, very, very handsome, and I'm in focus. I'm not moving. There's no jittering. The camera's not hunting. Oh, but I'm in manual focus mode. I'm not letting the camera do any focusing. I did the focusing before I sat down. I hand focused that. And therefore, my image is focused. But you say, I want to buy a camera. I've got kids, or I've got to do weddings. I've got to do something to make money, or I've got a family and I want to record them. I want it to focus properly. Well, that becomes very important then, doesn't it? So what are you going to do? You're not going to leave it in manual focus. You're going to get up. You're going to walk over to the camera, which is what I'm going to do right now. And I'm going to turn on the autofocus system and let you watch what's going to happen. Okay, I'll be right back. Boom, I'm back. Okay, now we're on automatic focus on the Lumix Panasonic GH3 camera. It's supposed to find me and focus on me. Let me put my eyeglasses on because I can't see the LCD screen too well. So it's supposed to follow me automatically. All right, now you say, how would it go and how would it be if we were on a very expensive camera, Peter? Do you have an expensive camera? I just happen to have my Nikon D800. Now we're going to put the D800 on and see what happens with that one. That should be interesting too. All right, let's check it out. I'll be right back. First of all, the GH3 never locked on focus. I checked the LCD on the back before I turned on the Nikon. Now you're looking at the Nikon D800E with the face detection on, and it's supposed to be finding my face and focusing while I'm talking to you. Right, Jingles? You see Jingles over there? The dog is sitting there. How you doing, baby? See, now this is what you would be doing if you had a family camera. You Somebody got a little excited. You would be getting your camera out and you would be taking pictures of your kids, your dog, kids at the baseball game, and you want the camera to focus. And you don't want it to hunt to figure out if it's in focus or not. Now we got two faces. We got his face and mine. I don't know if it recognizes a dog's face or a human's face, but this is the automatic focus on the Nikon D800E. You satisfied with that? You satisfied with that? Okay. Now, what happens if I wanted to turn sideways, pick something up, and then turn back so my face was out of the picture for a few minutes? Or if I wanted to lean back like Santa Claus, hello, and lean forward to make my point, this is similar to what you would be doing with a holiday camera. For Christmas, for Thanksgiving, for Easter, for Mother's Day, for whatever it is, kids' birthdays, you know, fun things, you would be getting the camera and you'd be using it and the automatic focus. Now remember, this is doing contrast detection. So in order to find out if the focus is on, it's got to go behind me and say, it's not that clear. Come back and say, oh, that's clear. And then double check, go forward, say that's not clear. And then come back to my face again. Now I'm hiding my face to see what it's going to focus on. Now I think this camera is going to do a better job because I can hear it jiggling, which is the sound of the lens. Now, let's do the same test with the Canon 70D camera. Canon 70D camera. I heard the lens moving. So I'm going to be surprised to see how you're seeing it ahead of me and how it's working. All right? So I'll be back in 1 second. Okay? Hold on. This is going to be the very first ever recording of any type I'm making on this camera. And here we go. Now, let's see. Did it catch me? Am I in focus? If I do the Santa Claus thing, oh, ho, 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 And I move in and out. Is it following the focus? Is it zipping back and forth like the Nikon did? Oh, I watched the LCD on the back of the Nikon, and I could see it testing constantly to see if it was in focus. The big test now is if this Canon 70D is doing the same thing or not. I could see the LCD, but you know, it's so small and so far, I can't tell what's happening. Now, what happens if I turn around and pick up that heavy object again? Oh, it's so heavy, and I'm going to put it on the table, and oh, it's heavy. Now, this is what your films are going to look like if you were actually going to use this camera and let it follow the focus of a person. Where is the little puppy dog, huh? Jingle bells, come over here. We're going to do Mary Had a Little Lamb and pick up my lamb. Come here. Come here. Come here. Come here. Come here. Come here. Ella. There we go. Yeah, there's the little lamb. Well, he's not quite a lamb, but he's a little white fuzzy thing. And how you doing? Don't put your head down. Look at the camera. You see the camera? You see the camera? Hmm? Okay. Now we'll do that other trick that I did where I covered my face. Now it doesn't have a face to focus on. And what is it choosing to focus on? I don't know. But now I bring the face back. Okay, let's walk over there. Okay, I'm going to walk over here. Now you got my back. There's no face in the camera, right? I'm going to sit in the chair, and I'm going to face the camera. Oh, now you want to come up. Now I'm all the way in the back here. I'm shouting a little bit louder. There's the baby. A little louder, and let's see how it's going to do. Now I'm going to get up, walk back over to my chair. And I'm not going to baby the camera. I'm going to get up. My head's going to go in and out of the frame. I'm going to sit down. And I'm going to tell you about the birds and the bees. The bird, the bees sting, the birds sing. There's the story. Everybody thinks it's such a difficult story to tell kids. The bees sting, the birds sing. That's the way it is. So anyway, so that's the first recording I'm making on the Canon 70D. I'm excited. I can't wait to go over there and see it. I'm going to see it ahead of you, but right now, you're actually seeing something that I am not seeing. So that was the Nikon D800 that we did. Okay, we did that. Let's see. The Nikon was able to focus on that. And, you know, I'm going to try the GH3 again, because for it not to even make an attempt to focus, that's pretty poor. They call that piss poor performance. Ah, I shouldn't say words like that. All right, now this is the GH3. Now it's handicapped a little bit because I've got a 14 to 35 Olympus lens, a stunningly good lens, but it's on an adapter. And yes, it's an electronic adapter. It's supposed to work with this camera with no problem. But what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make one more test. I'll run it right after this clip, and then I'll come back to this camera. I'm going to put the 12 to 35 lens on here just to be fair, because I'm very disappointed in what this camera did, and I hope I'm not disappointed when I get up and look at these, because you know, I have done videos like this with the camera on automatic, and all through it, it zips back and forth to try to get me into focus, which is very detracting to the user. So now this should stay rock solid while I'm sitting here. And I'll tell you about a story, and it should stay rock solid and not zip back and forth. That's the point of having all these sensors. 80% of the pixels on the sensor are actually being used for focus in the Canon camera. So you're getting the first view of the Canon 70D actually sitting down in an area. Okay, I do have a light in front of me. I do have light behind me, so it is optimum. But don't worry, there's times are going to be coming, and I'm going to be recording more and showing it to you. All right, let's do a really quick test again with the GH3 with the Panasonic, its own lens on there, because I feel it did so poorly, I'm embarrassed, all right? So I'll be right back. Okay, I put the GH3 back on and automatic focus. It's at f2.8 now, so it's actually using a higher f-stop. And I'm going to sit in here and see if it makes a difference. I didn't reframe the top, but it should be catching on my face and pulling in the focus. If it doesn't, I don't know what to tell you. So I'm giving it another chance because the other way it did so poorly, I might have misset something, but I checked everything and everything was fine. Set to continuous focus, face detection. I turned it on the same as I did with the Canon, the same as I did with the Nikon, but the GH3 didn't make an attempt to focus, which means if you're going to put the camera on the tripod, come sit in front of it and have one of those fireside chats. What's up, Doc? So I'm giving it this chance. Hopefully it's not focused on the background and it's focused on my face. I can't really see the LCD. And there, that's what we got going. All right, I'm going to go back to the Canon and close out. Well, actually, let's close out the show here, except if it's not in focus, it's going to be very poor. You just saw the very first attempt by me since the camera came in today to show you the difference between the different focusing systems, how they focused. I explained to you why they focus different ways, why this camera focuses differently. Another thing that this camera does is it's got the ability so that wherever you touch on the LCD in the back, it'll automatically go and focus to that spot. This becomes the focus puller. You tap on that person and it smoothly focuses right into that person. You tap on this person, it smoothly focuses right into that person. It automatically will focus to the spot that you tap on the LCD. It's stunning. I did play with it in the kitchen, and I'll make another video because this one's getting too long, and I'll show you the tapping feature. So you can actually be videoing your kids, and you can go between that one and then switch over to that kid, and the camera doesn't just go zip, zip, zip like it's, you know, nervous or something. It just pulls right in like you would see if you were sitting in a theater and it was done professionally. All right, that's a long enough video, isn't it, for the first one? But the 70D is just really an exciting camera. It's really a whole new ball game for many different types of people, from professionals to the industry to the guy at home that just wants to do his kids and the family events and what I call a holiday camera and have an awesome film camera. I mean, a still camera, not film camera. It doesn't take film, by the way. Please subscribe. I need more subscribers, so I have to ask. And of course, if you want to see any of these cameras and see them like on Amazon or see the reviews, I made a brand new website called More Peter Gregg. More of me. MorePeterGregg.com. You can go there. I just put it all in a list. You just click on the thing you want to see, and it'll either take you to the reviews or it'll take you to where I saw it on the internet, on Amazon, or any other place. And so just remember the website, morepetergregg.com. All right, this is Peter Gregg, Miami, excited with the first video coming from the Canon 70D. Talk to you later, guys. Bye.